Welcome to the Traveler's Book Review. My name is Lisa, and as some of you might know, the concept of this YouTube channel is to combine my traveling with my reading. So every time I travel to a new place, I choose a book about the place that I travel to, and also by an author that is from that specific country. So this time I landed in beautiful South Africa, and this country is so diverse, like the nature and the culture as well, which made my choice very difficult. But in the end I chose to read Marlene van Niekerk's novel Agaat. So this novel takes place in on a farm here in South Africa called Groenmotorsdrift, and portrays a few decades from the 1950s till the 1990s, and it's about the black servant girl called Agaat and the white farmer's wife Mila de Wet, and they have a very complicated relationship to one another, of course influenced by apartheid, but also other power structures make their relationship very complicated. Mila found Agaat when she was only 5 years old or so, so she actually raised her in her home, and Agaat became kind of like a family member, but as she grew older, the difference between them became more apparent, and she became more of a servant, and especially so when Mila got a son with her husband Jack, and the son Jackie becomes parented more or less only by Agaat. And this relationship only gets more toxic over the years, and power balance also shifts more and more towards Agaat instead of Mila, especially when Mila in the 1990s gets sick and gets paralyzed. Her whole body gets paralyzed except for her eyelids, which is the only way she can communicate with Agaat, and she's left totally to her mercy and her care. It's a very powerful book that explores the relationship between two humans, and it's also very interesting because it's not your typical apartheid book. It's set out on a farm, far away from the city and political life, and the characters are also just a handful, and you really focus on the close relationships between humans. And it is a historical book, but of course fiction. But I think a lot of people who like history would also like this book, and it's also very beautifully written. So if you're a sucker for beautiful and flowy language, this is definitely a book for you. For many of you, my dear followers, who are like me, travelers or students, this might seem like a handful to take on this book, which is 700 pages and a very heavy thing to carry around, but I would urge you to actually see past that and give this book a try, because it's really worth it. And if you do want to travel a bit lighter, this might not be the priority you have to put in your suitcase, then you can of course download it to your e-reader. And if you feel like you have some time when you're in the bus or something, just put on your headphones and listen to the audiobook as well. And please let me know, guys, when you've read this book, what you thought about it, and comment here below or send me an email or anything, because there's really so much to discuss about this book. So yes, start reading and get back to me. Otherwise, I'll see you at my next location. Bye!